Previously, we looked at three-point and four-point editing techniques in Smoke. Here are a few more editorial functions that you might use daily when cutting your production together. The first function you may want to perform when working in the sequence is to create a cut or splice, also called add edit or blade tool in other software. Press Ctrl V and this will splice the segment that is aligned with the focus point on the positioner. Notice only one track gets cut. Incidentally, cutting segments also works during playback. You can start playing the sequence, and by pressing Ctrl V, you can start cutting like you would cut to the beat if you were cutting to a music video. If you wish to splice across all the tracks under the positioner, press Ctrl Shift V. If you want to exclude any tracks from this multi-track splicing, simply lock the tracks with the padlock icon in the patch panel prior to splicing the segments. Extraction and lifting is another common editorial function that you might use. You can use the mark in and mark out markers to mark up the section for lifting or extraction. Or you can use selections. Press Option X to remove the in and out points in the sequence. Now you can make selections in a number of ways. Hold Command and drag the positioner over the sequence. This will create a selection from the start of the positioner to wherever you want. You can also hold Command and click the time bar to jump the positioner to make a selection. This is very useful to select everything before or after the positioner's original position in the sequence. Alternatively, you can explicitly select segments by holding Command and clicking the segments you wish to extract or lift. To lift a section from the sequence, press the backspace. This removes the section from the sequence and leaves a gap behind. I'll just undo that by pressing Command Z. To extract a section from the sequence, press Shift Backspace. This extracts the section from the sequence and closes the gap. Please bear in mind that using the extraction or lift shortcuts ignore the ripple setting for the sequence. However, you cannot extract or lift a locked track if the padlock is enabled. Finally, you can create a subclip from the sequence. You saw this in one of the earlier videos when I subclipped a source clip in the media library. To create a subclip from the sequence, simply mark up the area you wish to subclip and go to the menu bar and create subclip. You can do this quickly by pressing the Command U keyboard shortcut. This does not extract a section out of the sequence, but it does create a new clip in the media library containing the section that was originally subclipped from the original sequence. You can now select and edit it into another sequence. In the next video, you'll learn how to move segments around the sequence and the functions affecting their movements.